for me, it happened very quickly. I knew that I was a talented young swimmer, and I thought that that perhaps was what I'd always been. I didn't actually realize that potentially I could be the athlete that I became. You know, that kind of child prodigy that doesn't move to become what they potentially are or could be.
Straight, first in the 50 meters freestyle, first in the 50 meters backstroke, first in the 100 meters freestyle, and first in the 200 meters IM.
But I do remember a phone call that my father made. And he is not the kind of person that boasts about things. He's kind of, you know, super conservative, that kind of dad. But I remember him explaining or trying to explain what I'd accomplished in the pool. And I was a kid and I was like, wow, my dad's saying these things about me. And he'd never say that in front of me. Since I've kind of finished, he's now told me. I was like, well, I actually heard that. But it was one of those really sweet things that you never expect from your father. If I'm allowed to have a night of my favorite swimming memory for myself, it's the first night at the Sydney Olympics. I became Olympic champion at the beginning of the night. Strangely enough, I was told by different coaches that, you know, don't swim as fast as you can. Swim a little bit slower because you've got to save up for the next race that you have. So throughout Olympic history, the US had won every year. And for some odd reason, people actually believed that we could win this event, even though we were shockingly slow on paper compared to the US team, which was the first time that any country in the world actually had won it against the United States. You know, for me, it was everything.